Mark 9:43 goes on and says, going into the New Testament, "And if thy hand offend thee, cut it off. It is better for thee to enter into life maimed than having two hands to go into hell, into the fire that never shall be quenched, where their worm dieth not, and the fire is not quenched. And if thy foot offend thee, cut it off. It is better for thee to enter halt into life than having two feet to be cast into hell, into the fire that never shall be quenched, where their worm dieth not, and the fire is not quenched. And if thine eye offend thee, pluck it out. It is better for thee to enter into the kingdom of God with one eye than having two eyes to be cast into hell fire, where, again, their worm dieth not, and the fire is not quenched." Now, Jesus spoke about hell many, many times more, or several, whatever, a good amount more than he did about heaven and so forth, because he loved mankind. That's the love of God, saying, look, there's a hell here, and he's saying it's better for you to cut off your hand, pluck out your eye, you know, enter into life maimed, you know, and so forth, than for you to go into the fire that never is going to be quenched. And you hear Billy Graham and so forth teach that this fire is not literal. And I've heard other people say those things, this fire is not literal, it's not a literal fire. Well, if you don't believe in a literal hell fire, that's where you're going to end up, is hell fire. That's where you're going to go for all eternity, is be damned in the lake of fire. If you don't believe in a literal biblical hell, you'll end up in hell. So that's your problem for not believing the truth, Billy Graham and all those other false prophets that teach that garbage. Man, if you don't believe Jesus, and Jesus is speaking these things, in the book of John he says, if you don't believe my words, you don't believe in me. And these are his words. It says, where their worm dieth not, in verse 44, and the fire is not quenched. God's fire is not going to be quenched here, that he has set up originally for the devil. And when man sinned and entered in and so forth, and there had to be judgment for that. But the Bible says in Matthew 25, verse 41, I believe it is, that how everlasting fire was prepared for the devil, prepared now for the devil and his angels. Alright? Everlasting fire was prepared for the devil and his angels. Okay, that's why hell was created. Man, what every man or person, whether child if they're old enough to understand with the age of accountability and so forth, and woman and whatever, children or whatever that are old enough to know, and they enter into hell, that wasn't there created for those people. It wasn't created for mankind. It was created for the devil. It was created for his angels, and once man sinned, there had to be penalty for that sin. Wherefore, as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin, and so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned. So, and that's in Romans 5:12. Now, this is the penalty that's going to happen and fall upon you, these everlasting burnings and devouring fire and these unquenchable fire. If this isn't literal, I don't know what is. Nothing is then. Nothing is if this isn't literal. If Jesus isn't speaking here and speaking of a literal eternal hell, like many teach there is not eternal hell,